Hi, friends of cocktails. Today we're making magic by creating cocktails that change colors. Well, it's not technically magic, just basic chemistry. But that doesn't sound as catchy. We'll make three colored infusions of spirits, using pink rosebuds, red cabbage, and butterfly peat. Here's the magic part. We'll then use these colored spirits in three different cocktails, and while doing so, change the colors of these infusions. I'll get some help with a scientific explanation of this phenomenon, but you're here to see the magic happen, so let's start. It's cocktail time. This won't be the first time you're using red cabbage to add color to a cocktail. On our channel, we've made the red cabbage justino with cachaça for an elevated caipirinha. But calm down, Brazil. We made the classic one as well, and it was delicious. This time we'll infuse tequila with red cabbage, gin with pink rosebuds, and gin with butterfly pea blossoms. All three of our colorants contain a pigment called anthocyanin, which is basically what makes color-changing cocktails, and this episode possible. But I'll let a professional explain this better than I could. First, however, we need to impart some color to the spirits. Clear spirits is of course the way to go if you want to get the right color. I was experimenting with vodka as well, but it's just too one-dimensional. Gin and tequila add another layer of flavor, but you can of course try it out for yourself. I'm starting with the butterfly pea-infused gin. For that you'll need dried butterfly pea leaves and your preferred gin. I'm going with Tanqueray number 10. This gin is infused with fresh whole grapefruits, limes and oranges, among other botanicals. Start by weighing out 1 gram of butterfly pea leaves. This flower has several other names, but its scientific name points to the shape of the leaves, which resemble the shape of a certain part of the female anatomy. I'll leave it at that. Crush it lightly with a modeler to increase the surface area. Then measure out and add 8.5 ounces or 250 ml of gin. Close the lid, give it a stir, and leave to infuse at room temperature. The alcohol will start to leach out the color from the leaves immediately, but leave it to sit for about 2 hours. After that time, strain our colored gin through a cloth filter, and we don't want to leave any color behind, so squeeze it out of the filter. The most effective way is to use a potato ricer, especially if you make a bigger batch. Bottle, don't forget the label, and you've got yourself a beautiful small bottle of blue gin. For our second color spirit, I'll again be using gin, this time Bombay Sapphire. The bottle with Queen Victoria may look old school, but this gin didn't hit the market until 1987. I'll pair it with pink rosebuds to impart not just the color, but also a nice floral note. Again, start by weighing out the colorant, this time 2.5 grams of dried pink rosebuds. And model that as well. Same as before, the greater surface area means easier extraction by our gin. We'll add the same amount of gin we used before, 8.5 ounces or 250 ml. Avoid using a floral forward gin, since we're already adding the rosebuds. Bombay Sapphire or Beefeater are good, budget-friendly options. Again, stir to mix and leave to infuse at room temperature. Pink roses won't turn this pink, but yellowish, and not nearly as intense as with butterfly pea flowers, so I'll let this sit for 12 hours. After that, we again strain using a cloth filter. I prefer to use a muslin cloth, but a cheesecloth or even a clean kitchen towel would work as well. Squeeze out all the liquid once more, bottle it, and your second batch of color gin is done. And so we move on to the third and final infused spirit. To make the purple tequila, you'll need dehydrated red cabbage, and of course, blanco tequila. I'm using Ruste Rojo. I've mentioned the episode where we used red cabbage before. You can check that out if you need tips for dehydrating. But here I'll just combine 4 grams of red cabbage with 8.5 ounces or 250 ml of tequila. Ruste Rojo is the bottle that started it all. Check out the first two episodes of Cocktail Time for a little throwback. All of these batches are measured to fit my 250 ml jars and bottles, so just scale the colorant up or down as well, if you'll be making a different amount. We'll again leave to infuse for the next 12 hours. Then I'll do the same as with the two gins, strain, squeeze, bottle. I love the vibrant purple color that we get from cabbage. Make sure it's labeled, and you're ready to start the magic journey of color-changing cocktails. To understand why this happens, I turned to a chemist, who also makes cocktails. Darcy, take it away.
Oh, hey Kevin. So you want to know about natural color changing pigments? Let me explain. So what happens is that plants use these as signals to indicate free drink here, in the case of flowers and nectar, and in the case of fruits and vegetables, a free meal here. So as fruits ripen, the acidity goes down, which means the pH goes up. And when this pH change happens, the actual molecular structure of these pigments changes. And we see that as a color shift. So when it comes to actually using this in cocktails, these pigments, we can dial them in to have a very specific color in the case of certain pigments. One of the problems I find is that getting that perfect color often requires a very narrow range of a pH. So the solution I've come up with is to make a 10% solution of sodium citrate. It's found in the cheese industry and the beverage industry. It's pretty common, it's not hard to find. And you just add 10 grams to 100 mils of water, much like your saline solution. And this will allow you to adjust your pH in increments of a tenth to a quarter. And that will allow you to dial in the perfect pH so you can get the perfect color. So Kevin, show us which cool cocktails you've made today.
Thanks, Darcy. Anyone that likes geeking out over interesting cocktail stuff, you have to check out Darcy's YouTube channel, Art of Drink. It's a real fountain of information. I'll leave a link in the description. Now for the cocktails. We'll make a color-changing Negroni, gin and tonic, and a Tommy's Margarita. All simple and delicious. I'm starting with a Negroni. This will start off as a blue version of a white Negroni, with our color gin, Italicus, Bianco Vermouth, and Saline. We'll serve that in a low tumbler glass or a clear ice cube, with a grapefruit peel and a small amount of an acid mix solution, making sure to get the right acidity, but also flavor. I mixed 1 gram of citric, 1 gram of malic, and 1 gram of tartaric acid into 47 grams of water. If you don't have all of these, just use 3 grams of citric acid to make your solution. Mixing that into the cocktail will give us the color changing effect. But first, chill the mixing glass and add ingredients. Starting with 1.5 ounce or 45 ml of our blue gin. Butterfly pea flowers are also what Empress Gin uses to get its distinct color, but our homemade colored Tanqueray No. 10 is a wonderful choice. Follow that with 1 ounce or 30 ml of Italicus Rosolio di Bergamotto. Not as bitter as Sousse or other gentle liqueurs typically used in a white Negroni, but this will pair nicely with the sour style we're making today. After that, 1 ounce or 30 ml of Bianco Vermouth. I'm using Clostau Bianco Vermouth instead of the Le Blanc aromatized wine. This has some acidity as well, so you might notice a slight color change already. And as is traditional around here, 2 drops of saline solution. Then add ice and stir to chill and dilute. Dilution will raise the pH again, bringing the color back to a slightly deeper blue. Pour the cocktail over a clear ice cube and garnish with a grapefruit peel. Make sure it's a long strip and clean up the edges, since you'll use it to stir the cocktail afterwards. Of course, don't forget to express the essential oils first. And for the visual effect of the color change, 5 ml of our acid mix solution. That's a little under 1/4 ounce. Adding it like this gives your guest the option to enjoy the full visual effect right before enjoying the cocktail. Just make sure to stir everything again once you add the final ingredient. Cheers! The pH change is what causes the color change in the pigment of our gin, going from blue to a gentle pink. But with that, we're also adding a sour component to our Negroni, slightly taming its signature bitterness, making it more approachable to the masses. And it looks nice too, of course. A perfect summer version of the Italian classic. Moving on. Since we've been on a bit of a run with gin and tonics on Cocktail Time lately, I thought we might as well take a look at another way to give it color, then make that color change. Let's make a color-changing gin and tonic. For that you'll need a rose-colored gin, some saline solution, and your tonic water of choice. I'll serve it in a high tumbler glass or a clear ice pier, with a lemon peel garnish and a straw, which will make it easier to gently mix the tonic with gin for the full color transformation. Start with 2 ounces or 60 ml of our rose-infused gin. Like I said before, you don't want to go just in one dimension, so besides using the right gin for the infusion, also think about what tonic you'll add. But before that, add 2 drops of saline solution. That will enhance the flavors, same as with food. Then already add a straw and the lemon peel garnish. This might look like a half of a drink, but remember, it's about the wow effect. And I'm ready to take a sip, so it's time to add a tonic. I'm using the classic Indian tonic, but a Mediterranean would work nicely too. Gently stir with a straw, and it's easy to see when it's fully mixed in. Once you're done enjoying it with your eyes, it's time to smell and taste. It has a citrus aroma, but the floral notes are in the forefront on the palate. But with the right choice of gin, we made sure it's not overwhelming. Beautiful, balanced, and refreshing. Before we make the last cocktail, let's ask the question of the day. Is this just a party hack or something that can be a real trend this summer? I think it can be more than just a party hack, and made with care and precision. And blue gins have been around for a few years already, so it's not really a novelty. Pink tequila, on the other hand, the margarita we'll make just might be the drink of the summer. I'd love to hear your thoughts on the color-changing cocktails as well. Leave them in the comments below. Now, let's make the color-changing Tommy's Margarita. For this one, you'll need our not blanco, but purple tequila, agave syrup, and a little bit of saline solution, and lime juice, which will serve on the side, again for the presentational purposes. Fresh or super juice, both will work. I'll serve it over a clear ice cube, showcasing the color change more. And a salted rim will just let you know this is a Thomas Margarita, no matter the color. Start by adding 2 ounces or 60 ml of purple tequila into a chilled shaker. Follow that with our sweetener, half an ounce or 50 ml of agave syrup. Add 2 drops of 20% saline solution, a simple mix of 1 part salt to 4 parts water. Add ice and shake hard to chill and dilute. Double strain over the already mentioned clear ice block and serve with the side of 3/4 of an ounce or 22.5 ml of lime juice. With that, the cocktail is ready to be enjoyed by the guest, or you of course. First enjoy the beautiful color as is, then pour in the lime juice and once again witness the magic of chemistry as the cocktail changes color from the purple to pinkish red. Beautiful. Once stirred, you're ready to enjoy the first sip. You'll get plenty of citrus, just like with a classic Thomas Margarita. But here you'll get a subtle vegetal note on the palate, which just highlights our Blanco tequila. Again, if you want to go all out on the presentational effect with this cocktail, you can check out how to make lime juice fierce, as shown in the Caipirinha episode. Next week, we're showcasing another cool and innovative cocktail technique, which I'm super excited about. Make sure to subscribe, and I'll see you then. Cheers.